Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's a distinct pleasure to be with you here today. I would like to begin by recognizing and thanking the many Indonesian ministries and agencies that have played such an instrumental role in this delivery of ventilators. Minister of Foreign Affairs, Ibu Retno Marsudi, Pak Cecep Herawan, Secretary General of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Pak Oscar Primadi, Secretary General, Ministry of Health, our representatives from the head of the National COVID Task Force, as well as colleagues from Bappenas, Ministry of Finance, and BNPB. When a health crisis arises, America does not wait. We respond with timely and expert assistance, and we partner with nations around the globe. The United States has pledged ventilator assistance to countries around the world, including Indonesia, through the United States Agency for International Development, or USAID, and we're proud to deliver on this promise. Through the generosity of the American people and the innovation of American private industry, the United States is providing access to medical supplies and ventilators to Indonesia to fight COVID-19. Produced by Vyaire Medical, the 100 ventilators we're delivering today will give Indonesia greater flexibility in treating patients with COVID-19. As we battle this pandemic at home in the United States, we have also gauged our ability to support Indonesia and other partners and allies around the world. We are ensuring the availability of essential medical supplies at home, including ventilators, while also enabling America to lead the global fight against COVID-19. The United States, through the U.S. State Department, USAID, and Centers for Disease Control, is the largest contributor to global health, with more than $140 billion U.S. dollars contributed over the last two decades. Since the outbreak of COVID-19, we have committed the equivalent of more than 22 trillion Indonesian rupiah in emergency health, humanitarian, economic, and development assistance worldwide. This includes roughly 187 billion Indonesian rupiah in support to Indonesia in addition to the donation of ventilators. This generous support from the people of America is saving lives by equipping Indonesia's health workers with the tools they need, improving Indonesia's laboratory, disease surveillance, and rapid response capacity, accelerating case detection and tracking, and enhancing risk communications to ensure that more Indonesians know how to protect themselves and each other. The United States continues to help people around the world through an All of America effort. This donation of ventilators reflects our lasting commitment to partnership with the government and people of Indonesia to save lives and work toward the safe reopening of the Indonesian economy. It is indeed a great honor for me to be here today to represent my country as we recognize the partnership we have with Indonesia to fight the global pandemic. And I thank you all, Ibu Menteri, and all of my colleagues from the government of Indonesia for their partnership. Thank you.
Thank you, distinguished guests, colleagues from the media, ladies and gentlemen. We are here today to witness how partnership and collaboration is crucial in tackling COVID-19. This pandemic has triggered unprecedented global challenges that deepen the urgency of collective responses. No country can single-handedly beat this virus alone. Today, we have just witnessed a symbolic handover of 100 Vyaire ventilators from the United States. This is a follow-up of the phone conversation between President Jokowi and President Trump on the April 24, 2020. And I was informed that in total, there will be 1,000 ventilators from the U.S. delivered to Indonesia in separate batches throughout August. And on behalf of the government of Indonesia and the people of the Republic of Indonesia, I would like to extend our appreciation to the government of the United States of America to Indonesia. Colleagues, since the start, the Ministry of Foreign Affairs has facilitated close coordination and communication with all relevant stakeholders regarding preparation, technical arrangement, and logistical aspect. And I would like to underline that this handover event has provided us two important lessons. First, the handover of ventilators is a clear example of collaboration to address the pandemic. A collective response is key to overcome a global challenge of this magnitude. Second, I do hope Indonesia-US cooperation does not stop here. Going forward, Indonesia and the US will continue to strengthen our strategic partnership not only to mitigate COVID-19, but also to prevent future pandemics and to provide support for regional and global health governance. In this regard, both countries will work hard to enhance cooperation in various aspects, such as provision of medical devices, as well as on post-pandemic economic investment cooperation, including in the pharmaceutical industry. So by standing united, we recover stronger and prosper in solidarity. So once again, thank you very much.